and I was in charge of the surveys.
My name is Keisha Cora, and I was in charge of the PowerPoint.
My name is Lucia Slaixa, and I'm going to be in charge of presenting.
My name is Diana Hernandez. I did the writing paper.
My name is Andrew Cruz. I did the graph.
Tsunamis are giant waves caused by earthquakes or volcanic eruptions under the sea. Out in the depths of the ocean, tsunami waves do not dramatically increase in height. But as the waves travel on land, they build up to higher and higher heights as the depths of the ocean decreases.
The speed of tsunami's waves depends on the ocean depth rather than the distance from the source of the wave. Tsunami waves may travel as fast as jet planes over deep water, only slowing down when they reach shallow waters. While tsunamis are often referred to as tidal waves, this name is heard by oceanographers because tidal tides have little to do with digital waves.
Food supplies for family to last more than 6 to 12 months. At first, we have peanut butter, nuts and shell mixes, granola bars, canned meats or soups, cereal, and whole wheat crackers.
We can also use canned vegetables, multivitamins, powdered milks, sports drinks, and bottled water for hydration.
Hypothesis. We had suspected that most of the survey responses would be I don't know and no for the most part. We didn't exactly think that anyone would consider putting yes in some of these questions, since our school isn't exactly prepared.
We gave out surveys to people from our school. So we gave out about 50 of them.
As you can see from the results of the surveys, we can see that most of the age was about 13 to 15 years old. That was a 56%, a 38% were about 16 to 18, and the 6% were 19 and up.
Which would be staff and teachers. The grades were mainly ninth grade. We mainly surveyed ninth graders with 44%, and 10th grade with 11th graders with 35%, and 12th graders with only 1%.
In gender, we can see that mostly everyone was male, a 52% and a 48% were female.
It would actually be pretty fair. I was almost happy. When we asked if you were prepared for a tsunami, a whopping 53% said that they were, but a 47% said they were. It's kind of even, but still it's more that they're not prepared at all.
When we ask this, do you have an escape route in case of a tsunami that happens? Most of the people said no, and the rest said yes.
When we asked if people had non-perishable food to last in their homes, a good 60% said that they did, and 40% said they did.
And the question that we asked, do you have a backpack full of necessities like water, food, and a first aid kit? Most of a 52% said yes, and a 48% said no.
Yeah.
When we asked the students if they were aware of their social security, money, and ID, most people said they didn't know. 12% said they didn't have it, and 26% said they didn't know.
Does your school have enough food storage? And this, mostly everyone said, I don't know. A 50%, a 32% said yes, and an 18% said no.
When we asked if they felt if the school was ready, most people said no, 44%. Only 32% said they didn't know, and 24% said they were sure.
What did this survey teach us? The surveys we gave out taught us that most of us are not well prepared for a tsunami nor a natural disaster in the Oso, in Jania Maria de Oso. We have no clue to where to escape. We have no idea if our school has enough food or water supplies to last us.
So we suggest that when in coastal areas, we need to stay alert for tsunami warnings, we need to learn the details of local warning systems, we need to plan an evacuation route that leads to higher ground, we need to know the warning signs of a tsunami, not only rising or falling coastal waters and rumbling of an offshore earthquake. And we never have to stay near the shore to watch the tsunami come in, and we need to be aware that tsunami is a series of waves and do not return to an affected coastal area until offshore authority needs to stay at the same.
In conclusion, we thought that the answer is going to be, we're going to be mostly, I don't know, and no. And as you can clearly see here, we were right. Our school is not prepared at all. We do not know if we have enough food or water, like we said again. And we don't have an escape plan, nor do we have first aid kits in any classroom at all. Essentially, we are not prepared. We have absolutely no clue to do. Tsunami occurs.